Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's been a really long time and I even changed my channel name from One Page Tutor, tutoring the secondary school student, to Sunny Chan, which I will share about my life as a medical student. I'm currently in year 2 in a private uni in Malaysia. In year 1, I had 8 exams. So end of the block, we have exam, 6 end block exam, 1 midterm and 1 pro exam, which is the final. So in this video, I'll walk you through how I study in year 1. I've divided in 3 parts: my 3 ways of learning, how I maintain consistency, self-discipline, and my advice from friends, which I've questioned them if they were given the time to go back to the study break during pro exam, what would they do instead? Always make sure that you are studying smart but not hard. Studying smart is understanding the syllabus for the future, not to memorize blindly for the sake of exam. Part 1, 3 steps of learning. I understand, then I do a summarized note and I test myself whether I familiarize with the topic. So the first step, understanding. How many of you actually skip online lecture? So honestly speaking, 50% of time I listen attentively. So another 50% of time, either I doze off or I skip the lecture straight away to watch YouTube. But never skip tutorial, because tutorial is where lecturer tells you what is the main point and you get to review where you get it wrong, learn from mistakes. And I have a tactic here, which is to participate actively during classes, answer the question no matter you're sure or unsure with your answers. Once you get it wrong, the embarrassment actually make you remember the mistakes more. Another thing is always arrange your tutorial answers neatly on the same day, so you won't forget if you didn't jot down, and put emoji for what is the main point and what is the frequently asked question or where is the part that I neglected. Different emojis, because I'm using everything on iPad, so I get to search back the certain emoji to find the specific part that I want to see. Second step is YouTube. YouTube is my main source of learning. My 3 go-to YouTube channels are Ninja Nerd, Dr. Najib, Osmosis. Ninja Nerd have everything on the YouTube for free. Dr. Najib, to buy the membership, the actual price is $99 for lifetime access. That's once I received the promotion through email and bought it using $2. Third one is Osmosis. Doesn't have a lifetime access, you have to pay monthly or yearly. So as Malaysian, I go a sneaky way, which is to buy from Shopee for lifetime access. All the links are in the description box. Most of my friends actually prefer to watch 10 to 20 minutes video like Osmosis. I would say Ninja Nerd and Dr. Najib helped me the most because their videos are up to 1 hour. But actually short videos, they're actually chunking a big topic into a few parts. If were to watch a 1 hour video but linking everything together is better, because when you know how to link all of them together, it is better to retain in your brain. And when you're doing notes, you know how to structure your notes immediately instead of just small chunks like lecture slides. So there are interesting YouTube channels as well that relate to real life cases, which are Institute of Human Anatomy and Chubby Emu. So my tips on learning anatomy is understand from illustration or human model, then understand from cadaver. So human model or illustration, YouTube channel, I will watch the Noted Anatomist or Ninja Nerd. For textbook, I refer to Grey's Anatomy, Atlas Anatomy. Proceed to cadaver, mostly asked in exam. Cadaver YouTube channel, I refer to Institute of Human Anatomy, while for textbook, I use Natter's Anatomy. So there are people who actually prefer to understand from textbook. They prefer textbook over YouTube, which I cannot relate because I'm a visual learner. The only textbook that I use as a visual learner are pharmacology. I use pharmacology for medical graduates because it's more like a notes type instead of paragraph. Pathology, I use Robbins Pathology and Harsh Mohan. Part 2, note-taking. Many people actually think note-taking is time-consuming, which I agree, but if it turned out to be as lengthy as lecture slides, that is not an efficient note. It has to be summarized and compiled information from many sources. I make all my medical notes on an iPad where I get to scribble around, drag and drop the image from Google Do I have to waste the time on drawing all the complex anatomy structure? And I get to search notes, the specific subject word. I only use two applications for medical notes. One is notability for my lecture slides. The other one is good notes for my own notes. So now, how do I make efficient notes? I will first list out the topics and get idea how to structure my notes, draft the structure, then only start my actual notes. So all the ideas, where do I get? I get mostly from YouTube or sometimes from lecture slides or tutorials. YouTube video, very good at emphasizing the main points, where's the keywords, and they'll teach the topics in a precise form or in a formula form. So everything is linked together. So human brain actually remembers better in this way. Let me give certain examples. I'll take the hematopoietic systems pathology, the leukemia versus lymphoma. You can differentiate them in terms of definition and their subtypes. Leukemia, there's acute, chronic, and under both of them, there's myeloid and lymphoid. While lymphoma, Hodgkin, non-Hodgkin. Furthermore, compare them. So you can make comparison table. Second example is compiling the knowledge. So let me take lymphoma chromosomal translocation, which chromosome 12 translocate with chromosome 18 to form follicular lymphoma, chromosome 12 translocate with chromosome 8 to form Burkitt's lymphoma, chromosome 12 translocate with chromosome 11 to form mantle cell lymphoma. Once you compile, you can see chromosome 12 actually translocate with different chromosome to form different disease. Third example that I will take is from physiology on hemostasis chapters, two situations, injured endothelium and healthy endothelium. Injured endothelium, you have the hemostasis, and in the healthy endothelium, how to keep the blood flowing, how to inhibit hemostasis. Hemostasis, four typical processes are vasoconstriction, platelet aggregation, adhesion, coagulation cascade, and fibrinolysis, which there's more details under each process. And on the other hand, healthy endothelium, how to keep the blood flowing, you will have the opposite of injured endothelium. So you will have antiplatelet, which is like nitric oxide, prostacycline, anticoagulation, like protein C, protein S, antithrombin 3, fibrinolysis. Instead of remembering all of them in chunks, you can remember two situations and all of the details all together. Fourth example is using formula. So also physiology, but hemodynamics, which is blood pressure equals to cardiac output times total peripheral resistance. Cardiac output actually determines systolic blood pressure, TPR actually determines diastolic blood pressure. So with this, you another way to remember cardiac output and TPR. And cardiac output, you can derive another formula. Cardiac output equals to heart rate times stroke volume. And stroke volume, you can also remind yourself with the preload, afterload, and contractility. So my rules of making notes is less words, more diagrams. Ensure there's no repetition in your note. Multiple Google image on the same process, for example, hemostasis, each of the image has slight different in the information, but all of them talking about the same hemostasis. So when you revise back after a long time, you'll forget which diagram specifically to go to. So to me, I'll get information from Google image as well, but I'll make a standardized one. Second rule is do not copy paste lecture slides word by word. It will just end up being lengthy and without pointing out where's the important one. Why do I emphasize on making notes so much? So there are over 200 chapters that we have to learn in year one. So when finals, we only have 3 weeks of study breaks. Brain memory is so limited that you can only remember the main points. If along the way, you don't prepare, summarize notes, and in these 3 weeks, you will suffer a lot. Because you will tend to forget what you initially remember. Second thing, you get to summarize in your own way and gather information from many sources, from YouTube, from textbook, from lecture slides. And lecture slides, sometimes the sequence is disrupted and you have to arrange it again to make it flow like a story. And additional benefits of making notes actually helped me in making presentation slides straight to the point and visually pleasing. The third step, testing myself, which uses the active recall method. I tried group study and self-study. Group study, I actually tried with a friend. Both of us take different chapters and we share notes and teach each other. So teaching is a good way for active recall, but sharing notes, every people have their own preferences when it comes to note-taking. So I've tried this method with different people. So until this point, I know that I couldn't share notes, but there's another way of group study that I can do, which is to ask each other questions. also find someone who is similar level as you and tolerate each other study methods. So what I did is me and my friend responsible for different chapters, ask each other. We can make sure each other to cover everything and the process is fun. Once learning process is enjoyable, that's the best way to keep you going throughout these 5 years. On the other hand, the self-test, which is question banks or review flashcards, pre-made flashcards. Recommend this for question banks which are past medicine, web pathology, med school quiz, and King's Out. So for flashcard, I only use it for anatomy. So in self-test, doing question banks and reviewing flashcard, consistency is the key. You have to make sure yourself to do 20 questions every day. So accumulative, you'll do a lot of questions in the end. Not to do last minute. Same goes to note-taking. Note-taking, start from the first day, so you can make sure you do enough questions, familiarize with the case-based questions before exam. And another tactic that I use here is I screenshot those good questions or I think it's frequently asked questions and put it into my note and I put an emoji beside so I can search back.
Part 2, how to stay consistent.
Every day when you want to start studying, you need the motivation. So having a group of friends who shares the same passion actually made me feel motivated. And I have to stay alert and awake for me to start studying. I will take break intermittently by going downstairs, get some food, or talk to my family. But don't touch phone. Phone away from this room better, or just like away from this table, away from your sight. Another way to stay alert is when you're in the same room, study for long hours, you might need to change your environment, change to a spacious and near to nature. To me, that's effective. Add on green tea, my source of slight caffeine, stay awake, instead of depending on coffee to stay awake. So how to stay disciplined? Before entering into a new block, I will always do some preparation. I'll make checklists, reference lists, and good note files. So for checklists, we list out the subject in the block, what are the chapters, and checkbox beside with my study partner. And we get to see each other progress. This turns out to be a motivation. The reference list, you can put it into the checklist as well. Good note files is create the file, which include in year 2, there are these 6 blocks. And in that block, there are these subjects and the subject book cover with the first blank page. So when I want to do note, I straight away do note without the need of copy paste from the previous note. Second thing to make sure that I'm always disciplined is to plan my schedule ahead. Night, I will plan what should I do the next day. So the next morning, I can straight away check what I should do in the day and have a checkbox beside track the duration where I do this thing. And Notion, I also have a part where I can journal what I feel in the day, what I do in the day. So to be honest, Notion actually consumed me a few days to customize into my own style. Because at first, I don't know how to use Notion since there are tons of functions. And third way to stay disciplined is to know how much practice question that you haven't done. So I will put the practice question easily accessible on my iPad home or put it into my Google reading list. Fourth thing to stay disciplined is to have countdown app. For laptop, I'm using Special Day Countdown. This application actually reminds me every day when the clock hits 12 a.m. that how many days left. And the last way, which is the most effective way, which I use most of the time during first year, is to do study with me. You can search it on YouTube, the study with me video, or study with me with your friends. How I did is I turn on my webcam but turn off my mic on Microsoft Teams. With small pinch of motivation, whole lot of self-discipline turns out to be habit that keeps you going. Everyone has their own preferences when it comes to study methods. How to know which one suits you more? You have to journal down your experience on trying different study methods. Throughout the 5 years of medicine journey, you will try out many different study methods according to circumstances, whether you're busy, whether you're more free. To remember which suits you more, you journal down them. You journal down your experience, you journal down what makes you focus, what motivates you. So whenever you feel unmotivated, not focused, read back them. I have this really bad habit is to watch YouTube around 3 hours every day, whenever it's K-pop or anything. So to break this social media addiction, I add a Google extension, which is a website block that block all my entertainment. And also you have to understand yourself more in terms of your attention span curve. Like at which hour you're very alert, hour you're very tired and unmotivated. So for me, the most unmotivated hour is after meal. I feel like watching YouTube. So at that point of time, I will make myself to do practice question instead. Because if I were to read the lecture, it would just make me feel sleepy. Now brings us to the last part, which is advice from my friends on pro-exam preparation. So I asked them a question, if you are given a time to go back to the 3-week study break before pro-exam, what will you do instead, or what will you improvise your study method? Most of them commonly told me that they will master summarizing notes skill and build a strong base along the way. Before every MLOC exam, they will make summarized notes. And for pro-exam, they are familiarized with what's important already and use the 3 weeks wisely to do practice questions. The second common thing that they said is they will focus on the tips given by lecturers, especially during the revision classes that we had in the second week of study break. The lecturers kind of point out what is important by giving us the questions. Those questions are actually from the tutorials, and do back every tutorials because there will be similar questions. From this pro exam, I kind of realized something. Our pro exam format is we have 4 papers, objective, essay, OSPI, OSCE. So objective, we have 90 questions evenly distributed from each subject and came out from every block. So you can't cover so many things. You must know what is important and the special ones. There are something related to the special terms. Those are rare thing that I missed out and asked quite a lot in objectives actually. So what I did, because I don't know the answer, what I did is actually choose the longest answer, most bottom one, or choose the most special answer. So this brings us to the end of the video. I hope this video benefits you and keep on trying different study methods. Everyone has self-doubt. Just keep on trying and try your best. Don't aim too high to have too much expectation on yourself. Studying medicine can be tiring, but it's interesting as well. It's a very rewarding career. Thanks for watching.